Children, today's topic is finding square roots. In the starting of the chapter itself, I have told you squares and square root. That's vice versa. Square root is inverse of square. Okay? Inverse operation, actually. Now, let's see. The inverse, that is opposite operation of addition, is subtraction. That we know. And the inverse operation of multiplication is division. Similarly, finding the square root is the inverse operation of squaring. Okay, like this, square of 1 is 1, and if we find out the square root of 1, that will be 1. Squaring of 2 is 4. Then what is the inverse operation of in square root? Square root of 4 will be 2. Okay. Squaring of 3 is 9. Square root of 9 is 3. Isn't it the inverse operation? Okay. Now, in squares, what we do? We add repeated. Squaring a number is repeated addition of odd numbers. In other words, if we check 10, then it is the addition of or repeated addition of consecutive odd numbers that we had seen in the previous exercises. And square root is nothing but the inverse operation. What is the inverse operation of addition? It is subtraction. So it is repeated subtraction of odd numbers from the given square. That will end up to the square root of the given number. Let's see how it is. In this table, you can see square roots of squares and square roots of the of few given numbers. You can see squaring of 1 gives you 1, and square root of 1, just the opposite of, is 1. Square 4, square root of 4 is 2. So from the table you can just make out exactly what is square root. Here 6 square, it's square root, squares and square root till 10 it is given to you. Clear? Now, as I was telling you or talking to you about finding square root through repeated subtraction, we have seen finding squares through repeated addition, and now just the inverse of it, finding square root through repeated subtraction. Suppose 81 is the number, then what is to be done? 81 minus 1 is 80, then 80 minus 3, what is the next odd number in series after 1 is 3. And from the subtracted number, you have to subtract the next odd number. 80 minus 3 is 77. Now, 77 mein se aap kaun sa odd number subtract karoge? 3 ke baad odd number aayega 5. So, that is it. 77 minus 5, you get 72. Then, 72 minus 7 is 65. चलो आगे बढ़ो. 65 में से नेक्स्ट ऑड नंबर 7 के बाद आएगा 9. यू सब्ट्रैक्ट 9 फ्रॉम 65, यू गेट 56. लाइक दिस यू हैव टू कीप ऑन सब्ट्रैक्टिंग द कंसेक्यूटिव ऑड नंबर, नेक्स्ट कमिंग ऑड नंबर फ्रॉम द आंसर ऑफ द प्रीवियस सब्ट्रैक्शन टिल यू डोंट गेट 0. ओके, सो देन यू हैव टू काउंट how many odd numbers you have subtracted. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. How many odd numbers did you subtract? 9. So, square root of 81 is 9. Just like the squares you found out from the square addition of odd numbers, you had to just count how many odd numbers are added. Similarly, here you have to count how many odd numbers are subtracted, and you will get the answer to the square root of the given number. Isn't it interesting? Maths is actually, children, interesting. Only the thing is, you have to enjoy it. If you start enjoying this subject, you will never feel bored, or you will never run away from learning maths. Okay, so now we start with the exercise. Let's see exercise 6.3. and before going for the exercise, one more thing I would like to tell you. Finding out square root through prime factorization, which is actually our actual way of finding out the square root. The rest of the thing will be lengthy and tedious, or it's easy technique to get square roots of smaller numbers. But main workout which we are going to do is based on finding out square root based on, or the method through prime factorization. And we know how to prime factorize a given number by this division method. You can see here, right? An example is taken, 6400. Find out the square root of 6400. It's a four digit number, and no doubt, like me and you, you may think it in a different way, that 6400, if you take these two zeros, we can think of it's 64 multiplied by 100, square root of 100 is 10, and square root of 64 is 8. So 80 will be the answer. Let's check. But if it is through prime factorization, then we have to factorize it, divide the given number, long division method, where you are using prime factors only. You will not use composite numbers. Remember, prime factorize कर लो उसको, फिर आपको जोड़े बनाने हैं, pairs. You have to make pairs of like primes, like दो here, then two here, then two here, two here, two here. You have to pair it. Let's take that, get that number. Here it is. So pairing is being done. Then out of the pair, you have to take out one. Okay. After the two twos, one here from this pair, one two from this pair, one. How many pairs of twos are there? One, two, three, four. So how many twos we have written? Four twos and one pair of five. So one, five, and then you will multiply. 16 fives are 80. Orally, I have told you the answer, finding out square root of 6400. Orally only I told you, but then if you have to prime factorize it, then it has to be done like this. In all the numbers you can orally tell, but as we had two zeros at the back and 64, you can make out, it's easily you can tell it's square of 8. So 8 will be the square root of 64, and two zeros at the back, that means 100. So square root of 100 is 10. So that's how I told. But every time you cannot easily tell if the numbers are like this, 2352, or a number like this, 256. So not easy to say that. So we have to follow the prime factorization method and calculate out as I showed you this. So further practice you will get when I'll be solving the sums of exercise 6.3. Children, today we are going to do exercise 6.3, and the previous three questions we are not going to, actually two questions we are not going to do, that is question number 1 and question number 2, looking at the shortage of time, and that's not required also. Question number 3 we'll start with. Find the square roots of 100 and 169 by the method of repeated subtraction. So we will start with question number 3. We have two numbers, 169 and we have to find out its square root using repeated subtraction. And let's see how we can do it.